What in the world is a sweet spot on a baseball bat?
Spring has obviously sprung. It was Pittsburgh Pirates legend Rogers Hornsby who said, "People ask me what I do in the winter when there's no baseball. I'll tell you what I do. I stare out the window and wait for spring. The smell of cut grass, the roar of the crowd, and the crack of the bat. Why, did you know a well-hit ball is all about science? Step up to the plate." To swing for the fences on this question, the airship Curiosity didn't show up at the ballpark. We're at the Jefferson Lab in Newport News, Virginia. Jefferson Lab is a basic research laboratory built to probe the nucleus of the atom to learn more about the structure of matter. It also is a cool place to learn about the physics of baseball and the sweet spot.
Okay, well, the sweet spot is actually a term that's used more often than it's defined. I mean, it could have multiple definitions. And so when I refer to the sweet spot, normally I'm talking about the best place along the barrel of the bat to hit the ball in terms of what will make the ball come off the bat fastest.
When you hit a ball just right, you've hit it on one of the two sweet spots of the bat. One of these sweet spots relates to vibration. Whenever an object is struck, it vibrates in response. These vibrations travel in waves up and down the length of the object. At one point, those waves cancel each other out. That is the node. A node is a spot along a standing wave where the wave has minimal movement. Take a look at this drawing. See near the top of the bat where the red line and blue line are closest together? These are nodes, and that is where the vibrations are least when the ball hits the bat.
Everyone who has played the game enough knows that when the ball doesn't hit the bat on the sweet spot, it stings your hands. And what does that mean, sting your hands? It means that the collision is exciting vibrations in the bat.
Vibrations occur in all bats, aluminum and wooden. You feel it more in wooden bats because they are made of a solid piece of wood, following a process that has existed a long time. Hillerich and Bradsby have been making the famous Louisville Slugger bat since the 1880s. While ash is the predominant wood used, birch and maple are also employed. After the trees are cut in the forest and branches trimmed, the trunks are then cut into sections and shipped to mills. A worker will arrange these pieces on a mechanical lathe that turns the wood as it shaves off all the rough edges. The remaining piece is known as a billet. The billets are stored in a place to dry out from moisture and sap. The billet is then put on a lathe, which shaves off any excess wood until the shape of a baseball bat emerges from the original piece. It now closely resembles the finished product in terms of its shape, with a narrow end that is the handle and a thicker end that will be the barrel of the bat. These are sanded and undergo yet another inspection before they are separated according to their weight. The trademark is branded on the bat, and then it gets a bath and stain and a coat of varnish. Then it is ready to hit. So, where is the sweet spot?
You could just take this bat and tap it ever so lightly with a ball at different spots, and you find there's a spot like right here where the vibrations sound really very different. They're much higher frequency vibrations, and that's essentially the sweet spot. This is where that sweet spot is, and it's pretty reproducible. And that's very typical. You know, it typically appears somewhere between 5 and 6 inches from the end of the bat, and you know, virtually the same for all bats. I mean, all bats more or less look alike.
So what happens on contact?
When the ball hits the bat, a wave is created that bounces down to the end of the bat, bounces back, and eventually just bounces back and forth a bunch of times. That takes some time for it to get down there and back again. And by the time the reflected wave gets back again, the ball has already left the bat.
When the ball collides with the bat at a node or sweet spot, the bat vibrates less, and so less energy is lost into the bat from the collision of the ball and the bat. With more energy, the ball travels further.
Now, fortunately, in terms of the definition, you know,
the various possible definitions of where the sweet spot is, like where you get the biggest bounce off the bat, where it is the batted ball speed the highest, where are the vibrations minimized, they're all about at the same point. You know, that's typically at a point maybe 5 or 6 inches in from the tip of the bat. And really, from the point of view of hitting the ball and, you know, making the vibrations go away and getting the highest batted ball speed, there is one point that is the best point, but really anywhere within, you know, maybe a 2-inch band would equally suffice.
Did you know a batted ball travels farther on a hot and humid day? We think of humidity as something that's added to the air on a hot, muggy day. So you might think that a ball would go farther on a dry day than on a humid day. But for every water molecule that we add to the air, we have to remove a heavier nitrogen or oxygen molecule. Since the addition of humidity actually makes the air less dense, a ball will go farther on a humid day than it will on a dry day.